Everybody, and welcome back to school. Yay! We're very excited about a brand new year. And one of the things that we have found talking to students and to parents is that one of the biggest challenges of back to school and going into middle school is the transition into using our Powerschool Learning pages a whole lot more. So basically, I want to run down for you, what is Powerschool Learning? How do you use Powerschool Learning? This can be a really great resource for you throughout the year as you go, oh, where do I look for that bit of information? So first off, Powerschool Learning is a web portal. So that means every student has their own individual login. You as parents have your own login as well. If you need help getting that, you can contact the front office. They can get you that information. And basically what happens is that inside this web portal, every teacher has their own website. And so your student's account links only to the teachers that they have on their schedule. And when you get to this main homepage, you're going to be able to see each of their classes listed out. It'll look something like this. So one of the reasons that we're going to use this throughout the year is that it keeps students more organized and it makes sure all of their information is in one place. Now, of course, each teacher uses it slightly differently, but I want to run through the main features that you'll be looking for. All right, first I want to start with what we call the homepage. So this homepage is where the classes are listed out, right? And you'll see a calendar here in the middle of your screen. So this calendar is tied to all of the classes that your student is registered for. So underneath it, you'll see upcoming events listed out. This is a great place to check for upcoming tests, homework assignments, quizzes, because a lot of those things are going to get listed out right here. This is kind of a one-stop shop. Now, understand that not every teacher is going to put the homework in on that calendar every night. You still need to check your student's planner or agenda to make sure that you have the most up-to-date information. Once you're ready to get more specific information about your classes, all you have to do is click on one of the classes listed over here on your page. So, for example, you click on my class, which is language arts. What it's going to do is to take you to the homepage for that teacher. All teachers in Winston-Salem Forsyth County Schools are required to have certain information on their website. That's going to include their email, their contact information, if it's a phone number through the school, however they want you to do that. It's going to have information about after-school tutoring. It's going to have information about discipline in the classroom and what that's going to look like. And it's probably going to also include some information about class expectations as far as school supplies, resources needed, due dates, any of that type of information. So, for example, you look at mine and you're going to see some of this information listed out here on the homepage. Every teacher has control over what they're putting on their tabs over here. So they're all going to look a little bit differently. Many teachers organize it by time blocks, it might be by unit, it might be by week. That's gonna vary just a little bit, and you'll have to spend some time looking at them to figure out what's gonna work for your students' classes. One of the biggest resources I really want you to pay attention to is the calendar. So the calendar is up in the top bar. See it right here. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna click on that calendar and it's gonna redirect you to a calendar specific for that teacher and that class, which is a really useful way to access upcoming projects, upcoming events. Another feature that many parents find very useful is the messaging tab up here at the top, right near where it says calendar. So you go to inbox here and access your inbox for your account. So that might be yours as a parent or it might be yours as a student. Either way, it'll let you message the teacher that's in charge of this class website. Now, a couple of words of warning about this. A, it's not instant, okay? Most of the time, email is gonna be much faster. B, it does have a very heavy filter on it, so if there are any words that might be even remotely questionable, Powerschool Learning will kick it back, and the teacher may not actually see that message. So just be aware that you're gonna have a longer turnaround on using Messenger inside of Powerschool Learning than you will picking up the phone or sending an email regularly. Just not that it's a reason not to use it, it's just something that you should be aware of as you're making use of this tool. I really hope that this video of a brief, very small introduction to Powerschool Learning is helpful to you guys. We always have lots of questions here at the school about what is Powerschool, how do we use it, and we wanted to make sure that that information was in your hands. As always, if you have any questions, reach out to the teachers, reach out to the front office staff, reach out to our administration. That's what we're here for, and we're really looking forward to working with you through this brand new school year. Bye!